a country we're sitting on a bit of a time bomb here in terms of the lack of physical activity that many young people have in their lives, as it's been proven, it's been identified that unless there's positive steps taken to engage more young people in physical activity, the health issues are going to get worse and worse, and it will have serious consequences for this country over the next few decades. Well, I'm Robert McCargan, Chief Executive Officer of A&M Training. My background has been youth work. I've been a youth worker at both the frontline service delivery level and management level for the past 25 years, working in different settings across Scotland. Children's homes, frontline youth work settings, charities and the likes. 5 years ago, Andy and I got together and set up A&M Training.
Coming towards the end of my football career, I wrote a book. Well, I didn't write a book, Mark Weedy wrote a book for me, and one of the last chapters I said that I would like to go and speak to young people about some of the problems that I'd faced with both in and out of football, and try and use my experiences in a positive way to maybe help some of the youngsters fill in about the schemes that they work in.
The areas we work in are all areas that feature in the top 10% of the Scottish Index of Multiple Deprivation. And anyone who knows issues about poverty knows that risk factors are increased greatly for young people and their families who live in these communities. Their health is at risk because they're not getting good advice in terms of diet. They can't afford physical activity. Many can't afford to join gyms or, as we say, football clubs or dance or other sports clubs just because they are too expensive.
I think as well as that, both me and Robert came for these areas, you know what I mean? So, and football for me was an escape route out of the schemes. I grew up in Castlemore, and for me, when I seen how expensive football had become, I mean, football would have been out of my reach when I was a kid, when I was their ages. So, the fact that there's a lot of talent out there as well, with kids that just can't afford to play football. Football's meant to be a national sport, and cost should never prohibit anybody from playing sport, in my opinion, anyway.
We've got 23 football teams that participate on a Friday night, and every single one of them will have young people from minority ethnic backgrounds involved in them. Maybe one or two, maybe 10 or 11, but you know, that is evidence that the football is a universal language, and regardless of where you come from, if you can play football, you're part of our team.
As you say, football is international. Listen, it's really rewarding, you know what I mean? You see, a lot of the kids, we've seen them for 12 and you see them growing up to 16 and turning into, you hope, good young men, you know what I mean? And we like to think we've played a good part in that. Me and Robert are the first point of contact on a Friday night or that, so we've been there. Because sometimes coaches maybe change, but we've been the one constant in a lot of these kids' lives for the past 4 or 5 years, so it's... It can be challenging as well, as you can imagine. We've got 200-300 boys out on a Friday night. I'm not going to say it's all sweetness and light, but listen, 99% of the time it's really enjoyable. We always get the wee 1% of hard work, but no, listen, by and large it's a really rewarding job as well.
Sometimes pictures are better than words, and I think if you see what's behind you, that shows the value of what we do. And no matter how often we do it, we still get a lot of enjoyment out of seeing these boys just mixing, being involved, being here. Obviously, there's the dancing inside as well. There's probably 30-odd, mainly young women, in at the dancing, rehearsing for shows and activities that are coming up. Of course, this is rewarding because we're doing what we set out to do, and we're doing it very well. And you know, young people see the benefits of it. We see the benefits. Our coaches absolutely love it. I can assure you, coaches don't do it for the money. They do it for the experience. Being part of the A&M team is good in a CV as well.
And a lot of these coaches grew up in these places as well. Although some of them have maybe made a career in football or outside football, whatever, they still, it's for them, it's getting a wee bit back as well. Because they grew up in these communities and they, They get people like us coming and taking them for football and helping them along in life as well. So it's probably a way for them to get a little bit back as well.
We believe this should be replicated across Scotland. Why should it just be in Glasgow? And why should it only be in selected areas within Glasgow? It saves money in the immediate term, in the medium term, and in the long term. We believe it will be saving money in terms of health, in terms of reductions in crime and disorder, in terms of young people having more skills that will make them more employable in the future. It's a win-win for everyone, and we believe that with the right investment we can be replicating this in different parts of the country. We just need the support of the people who are actually holding the purse strings just now to allow us to expand and to share what we're doing in Glasgow with the rest of the country.
I think coming from the football side as well, I think there's a lot of untapped talent out there. The boys out there who are basically getting priced out of football as well. So for the football side, for me, a lot of the ethnic minorities as well, they're an untapped pool for clubs in Scotland as well. You know what I mean? A lot of these guys are very talented, but they just need an opportunity.